以下为个人意见节目，内容提及的所有政纲及言论均以嘉宾原话为准，敬请留意。
市选论英雄 Municipal Election Talks， 节目主持谢安华。
各位听众朋友，你们好，现在又是市选论英雄的时间了，我是今日的节目主持人谢安华。今天我们很高兴请到康山市选区的教育局委员候选人 Anastasia Soropakis 和我们去聊天，希望呢我们从今次的节目里面呢更加认识这个选区和这个候选人的。 Hello Anastasia。Yeah, welcome to the Canadian Chinese Radio. Would you like to say hi to our audience?
你好吗？
Oh, wonderful. He speaks in Cantonese. 哇，我们现在的候选人很多都多才多艺，他们都用中文跟我们打招呼的。Hey, Anastasia, would you mind tell us something about yourself?
Sure. I have three children, and they all have gone or are going through the public school system. I've sat on the German Mills Parent School Council for about 10 years.I've served chair for six of those years. And in addition, I also sit on the German Mills Community Board, which is responsible for the administration of a historic one-room schoolhouse. And my husband and I own and run our own self-storage facility in Toronto.
Oh, you know, Anastasia, 她本身已经有三个小孩，她是一个妈咪。另外她在服务这个社区方面，她已经在 German Mills Public School Parent Council, 即是一个 German Mills 的这个教育局的学校家长会里面呢是做这个委员有成十年之多。在这个家长会里面呢，其中的六年呢他是做这个家长会的主席。另外呢他亦都在这个 German Mills Community Board， 即是说呢在 German Mills 一个社区的委员会里面呢是负责行政，是帮助一个很有历史价值的，虽然是一间小小一间房的屋仔呢，是里面做一些教育工作的，他是负责这个教育小屋的行政。另外他和他先生呢也都是有自己的生意，就是一个自助式的储存服务，在这个多伦多的社区里面的。 Wow, you are a mother of three, you have your own business, and you still spare your time to serve our community. That's really great. I don't know how you manage your time. That's wonderful. Hey, maybe you can tell us something about yourelectoral area. So what's the area will be covered by your position?
Okay, so my area is Ward 1, Thornhill Markham, and Ward 5, Thornhill Vaughan. So that runs from east to west would be Don Mills to Dufferin, and then north to south would be Steeles and Highway 7. And that's a new area. This is the first election year that they've done that. They've combined, the public school board has combined these two wards together with one trustee to serve them. There are about 24 schools, I want to say, high schools and public schools, elementary rather, included in the mix. It's a very diverse area, and I believe I'm a good representative. I also graduated from Thornley Secondary School in Thornhill, so that's Bayview and 7, just south of 7. So I'm a product of this community, and I came back to this community because I believe in the community. It's a fantastic place to raise your children, and we have an amazing dynamic education system here.
Wow, so you grow in this area, you graduate from the area, you come back and give back to the society. That's wonderful. Okay, let me... get your message to、
Absolutely.
Our audience first. Anastasia 咧讲咧，佢今次嘅选区里边咧系好大嘅 ，is combined， 所以系将两个合并噶。咁佢以前咧就系康山市嘅第一区，就系由 Yonge Street 由 Yonge 去到 Don Mills。咁而家咧，除咗康山市由 Yonge 去 Don Mills 之外咧 ，extend 咗啦，就去咗去扩大到去我哋嘅旺市里边嘅 Ward 5， 旺市嘅第五区就去到 Dufferin。咁原先咧就係去到 Yonge 嘅啫，而家由 Don Mills 咧直至去到 Dufferin 噶。咁另外北邊咧就去到 Highway 7，就七號公路啦。南邊咧就 Steel 大道噶。咁即係話咧，將以前嘅兩個選區咧合併一個大嘅選區，係今年新嘅規劃。咁對嚟講咧，佢話係比較複雜，因為呢個咧係一個挑戰，佢要應付兩個選區嘅學校，同埋有兩個市嘅市政府，分別就係喺康山嚟講咧就係萬錦市政府 City of Markham 喺。康山市的另一边 Yonge 的另一边呢就是 City of Vaughan， 咁係兩個 city 嘅，係兩個市政府嘅。咁另外喺選區裏邊咧，有24間學校咁多，其中有係我哋嘅小學啦，亦都有我哋嘅中學嘅。同埋喺呢個社區裏邊咧，係好多元化嘅社群喺度嘅，有唔同嘅族裔。咁我希望咧，通過佢喺以前呢個社區畢業，佢都喺呢個 Thornier 啊 Secondary School 喺呢個係 Bayview 啊灣景大道同埋 Highway 7嗰附近嚇，就喺嗰度畢業嘅。佢喺度長大，喺呢間學校畢業。佢希望咧利用佢喺呢一方面嘅經驗，亦都希望服務翻我哋嘅社區，喺我哋教學委員裏邊咧係盡一分力嘅。So wonderful. Okay, in that case, maybe you can tell us some of your political agenda. Why and how you can achieve your political agenda?
Well, okay. So I have always been involved in my children's formal education. From the moment my first son went to kindergarten, I was involved somehow in the school. I helped whatever I could do. So I've been a strong advocate for parental engagement in our schools. I know what it takes to run a successful business and how to make smart financial decisions, and I believe these qualities make me an ideal candidate for trustee in our public school. I can make intelligent budget and policy decisions on a board level, and I can direct to the parents and the community as a whole. I believe that the school is the anchor of our community, and I propose to maintain an ongoing and interactive relationship with both parents and the community. I believe that you need to have a regular dialogue. It's crucial to successfully educate our students, and then they can go out and participate in the community, like I have. I've come back and I've done the same thing.
Right. Wow. You're really passionate about the education. 嗱，我哋嘅候選人咧，佢就話咧，佢又好熱心參與呢個教育嘅工作。佢嘅細蚊仔就算喺 kindergarten， 即係話喺佢幼兒班嘅時候咧，佢已經係同學校咧去磋商啊啲教育上嘅議題嘅。佢係喺好嘗試去爭取係家長參與教學嘅機會，參與學校既定嘅政策嘅機會嘅。所以由佢細蚊仔開始入學，佢已經有開始喺呢方面嘅工作，同埋咧佢自己覺得喺佢嘅生意上面，佢累積咗好多經驗，希望呢啲喺佢生意上嘅經驗咧，可以喺教育局裏邊幫助喺啲經濟上、財政上嘅決策，令到佢更加喺預算上面咧。是一個好的決策，令到資源的分配是更加有效去運作，令到我們的教育局能夠提高教育的質素。令他覺得這個好的財政預算，如果能夠在個教育局裡面去發揮的時候，他能夠直接去影響到我們教育質素，而不是好像以前那樣只是有一個家長去發聲，他能夠直接參與這個教育局的時候，他能夠發揮更大功效。而另外他覺得呢，學校是我們社區的基礎，如果他能够维持一个开明、进步、互动式的关系，在这个社区上面，等我们的家长和学校呢，是可以有一个直接的对话呢，他觉得这个是一个成功的因素，令到我们的学生呢，在学校里面，在课堂里面学到的东西呢，就是能够应用在这个社区，就好像他自己一样，他学以致用，他学识了这么多的学识，有自己的生意，在社区上去發展的時候，他現在是回饋社會，可以利用他以前在課堂的學識是帶回來這個社區。 Wow, you really is a living example. Yeah, you learn from the classroom and now you utilize it and apply to your business and also bring it back to our society, to our community. So maybe tell us more about the reason that you still you are so passionate about the education, and what's your plan in the coming few years to work for the education?
I believe that students, they need a lot, they need the community to support them. They need all of these resources in order to enrich their education. It's not enough to just have books. It's not enough to just have the class time. In addition, I also think that the teachers also need our support. They need extra resources in order to enrich the programs that they're teaching. I know there's a lot of parents have spoken to me about the math curriculum. It's been in the news. EQAO has said that our math scores are declining. Obviously, that has to be revisited. I don't know exactly what can be done initially, like in the first year, but definitely if I do get elected, I want to have I want to have an active role in doing something, because I don't think it's fair. I speak to a lot of parents and they take their children to private tutoring companies, and that's an equity issue. There are some parents that can't afford to take their children to tutoring so that right. they can pass a course, not do better. It's one thing to want to take your 70 and make it a 90. It's another thing to just pass the course so they can get the credit. That needs to change. That has to be readdressed, because again, it's an equity issue. Some kids can and some kids cannot, and our board is about equity.
Yeah, that's pretty true. Wow, I haven't paid attention to that. Thanks for reminding me. It's an equity issue more than just education. 嗱，咁我哋又讲讲咧，头先我哋嘅候选人 Anastasia 咧，佢就话佢希望多啲嘅资源可以帮到我哋嘅学生。佢话唔单止课堂里边嘅教科书啊。或者是多些的教学时间方面的，他觉得还有其他方面的质素他需要去配合。另外他觉得教师方面呢都需要多些的支持，在他们的、教育的程式上面呢是多些的丰富的资源，让他们教的时候呢更加是多些的、科目、多更加的丰富多姿彩。他希望呢不单止就是说看个分数，他说看到很多的调查，例如我们的数学 MAT、我们的 EQAO、那些评审成绩呢近年有下降的趋势，他觉得这只是其中一个指标，不应该是单是看这些的。另外看见呢由这些指标呢，很多家长就心急了、我们的数学成绩好像低了，就会去带些仔女去一些私家的补习学校 private tutor， 他们去到私家补习学校里面呢是帮助他的仔女成绩呢希望更加迈进，譬如说由低分去到高分、由70分去到90分、由不合格去合格这样。但是觉得呢这个是带出另一个社会的问题，就是这个 equality 的问题，就是说平等机会。因为不是每个家长呢都可以是有这个经济能力呢给我们的子女呢去一私人的补习学校去帮补的。如果在学校里面课堂里面去吸收到多少就是多少。但一些比较充裕的家庭呢是可以能够带着子女去到一些私人的补习学校。在这方面呢我们的候选人就说，如果他能够加入到这个教育局，他希望呢能够发挥他的影响力，希望减少这个、用私家补习的需要，希望在课堂里面呢已经充分帮助到每一位学生。成绩方面如果有不足的地方呢，在课堂里面呢老师用不同的资源呢能够帮到学生，于是乎学生呢在下课之后不需要再去找私家的补习先生。这方面就是其中一点我们的候选人他希望入到教育局之后呢能够发挥到的。 OK, that's great, you help out the、less affluent student, so make it more equal opportunity for all the students. So apart from that, any other ambition or other planning that you might have in your coming terms if you are elected?
If I'm elected? Basically, I want all of the schools to have equal access to board funding, to whatever is allocated to them by the board. Everybody should have that funding, and it should benefit the classroom. In the end, it has to benefit the children. That's why we're here. If the schools are functioning at an exceptional level, then the property values increase. People want to move into the community. You have more value for your home or your rental property or whatever. Everybody benefits. Don't think that voting for school trustee is simply a person that has children within the school system. It affects everybody. Like I said before, the school is the anchor of our community, and if the school isn't stellar, isn't right. exceptional, you know for a lot of people their homes are their pensions, it's their retirement. You're maximizing, it's like an RSP, you're maximizing right. your retirement program.
Wow, I haven't thought about that. I thought education is education. Wow, it does relate to our financial situation too. Mm-hmm. Maybe let me translate this one first.
Absolutely.
And then go back to you. And then you can tell us a little bit more about how the funding is unequal at this point. Okay, 我现在讲说，他首先候选人就说，如果他能够当选的话，他希望在教育局里面能够争取平等的资源调配。现在在教育局里面呢，某些学校或者某些区别的学校呢，是个资源调配是不平均的。他希望呢能够平均调配这些资源，令到不单是学校课堂里面的资源是平均。他说希望呢是、能够在个教育质素里面呢能够提高到、每个社区里面的教育质素。因为资源平均的时候呢，每间学校呢都能够提高他的教育质素，而不是某些社区或者某些学校能够提高他的教育质素的。他也提到一点呢，我们都以前可能没有留意到的。原来教育 唔单止系影响我哋嘅学生嘅，都影响我哋个区内嘅物业价值。因为如果嗰个教育质素好嘅时候，学校嘅声誉好嘅时候，嗰区嘅物业价值都会提高。呢方面我哋大家都好留意啦，喺名校区嘅物业咧系会贵啲嘅。所以咧，我哋话好多人咧，其实喺我哋间屋嚟讲，可以系我哋退休之后嘅一个依靠。因为间屋咧系我哋一啲嘅资产，有啲人咧系利用间屋咧系去按咗佢咧喺变咗退休嘅时候咧就可以安享晚年。所以如果我哋系投资喺教育方面，其实唔单止我哋选一个系教育委员咁简单，亦都系间接影响紧我哋将来嘅经济同埋财政状况嘅。咁呢方面咧系个新嘅体会。咁好多谢我哋候选人提醒我哋。咁头先佢讲到咧系教育资源里边有啲唔平均嘅分配，我想佢讲多少少教育资源里边喺而家嘅现行教育局有啲咩唔平均嘅分配噶。Hey Anastasia, you mentioned something about you would try to make it equal for the funding resources to different school.
Right.
How does it work at the moment, and how would you like to see in the future?
Well, they have a very complicated formula. I think they do it on purpose so that, you know, you don't ask a lot of questions. Maybe, who knows? But the York Region District School Board covers a very big area. There are rural areas.
Right.
Yeah, there are rural areas. There are urban areas. So when you get funding for your schools, sometimes the funding for children in East William Berry, there's different needs for schools in East William Berry than there is, which is rural.
Right.
As opposed to Thornhill near Steeles, which is almost Toronto.
Mm-hmm.
Are we being considered fairly? Another issue, I have a lot of parents coming to me and even community members coming to me about the new developments in York Region require new schools.
Of course.
The new schools are beautiful, right?
Usually it does.
Yeah. What are they doing for our old schools? How do we have new libraries? Do we have beautiful lighting? Mm-hmm. You know, and we're told by the board, the developers, they pitch in and they help. Well, then if they're pitching in to help, that means you got extra stuff for us.
Right.
My personal experience at German Mills, we wanted to get some retrofitted lighting in our gym for stage mm-hmm. plays. That was very difficult to get. Parents right. raised resources for that. But again, we can't keep going back to the parent pocket. We can't. It's the same pocket. The pocket that pays for pizza lunches, the pocket that pays for trips and everything. It's one pocket. So that's what I would love to look at. I would love to see that. I'm not exactly sure what the funding formula is, like I told you.
Mm-hmm.
But I'd like to see, because it is a hugely diverse area. It's different from Toronto Board because we have all these different communities.
Right.
And, the more we know about the other regions in York Region, it enriches what we know about our community, right?
Mm-hmm. So if you can allocate some resources from the newly developed area to the more established area
right.
for some retrofit,
retrofit,
or some upgrade, that would be great.
Yeah,
right?
For sure, because some of these schools are 40 years old.
Right.
Right. So
that's not fair, right?
I don't think so.
Really? Okay, give me 1 minute to translate.
Yeah, no problem.
嗱，咁啊，我哋候选人 Natasha 咧，佢提到而家嘅现行嘅资源分配咧，嗰个程式咧系好复杂嘅，佢好难三言两语去解释俾我哋听。但系基本上一啲好大嘅方向性咧，就系话喺我哋嘅 rural， 即系比较郊区嘅，或者 urban 同埋比较市区嘅學校咧，佢得到嘅調配資源係唔同嘅，因為嗰個人口嘅比例各方面咧，與資源調配好唔同。咁但係間接嚟講，亦都影響咗學生接受教育資源嘅機會，間接影響咗佢哋嘅教育質素。咁覺得呢方面係唔公平嘅，應該喺郊區或者市區類別嘅學校咧，都應該得到平均嘅分配。而另外啦，佢睇見新發展區發展商咧係會投入資源。去起一啲新嘅學校，有大嘅班房、好嘅設施，咁新發展區嘅學生固然得益啦。咁但係睇翻一啲比較舊嘅社區裏邊咧，舊嘅學校佢哋連一啲新式啲嘅空調啊，或者係燈光啊都冇嘅。佢哋好多時要自己家長會去籌款去改善呢啲嘅燈光系統、照明系統啊，或者基本嘅設施。佢覺得呢方面咧仲要好唔公平。因为不可以下下咧都系单系由家长会去筹款嘅，因为始终筹款力度有限啦。如果将来佢能够平均调配资源嘅话咧，喺啲旧啲嘅社区能够拨到啲资源咧，去帮助佢哋去改善现有嘅设施，而唔系就系单系发展新社区嘅学校。咁觉得呢方面咧系需要做得到，令到新旧社区啦，或者系归纳做郊区市区嘅学校咧，都有一个资源嘅平均调配。Okay, it sounds really quick about the equality in the opportunity and the funding.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. That's wonderful. Okay. Any other plan that you might have for your coming term?
I'm not sure. I'd have to. I think that's a lot on my plate first. I know that when you come in as a trustee, a new trustee, the learning curve is very big. I want to stress my accessibility to parents. I want to stress my accessibility to the community. I think that's important. We are working for you.
Right. 咁我問緊啊 ，Estacia 咧喺嚟緊幾年咧，佢就會有咩大嘅計劃？佢話咧嘅計劃方面咧，其實咧佢都要係啊邊學邊做，因為呢個係對佢嚟講一個新嘅挑戰。佢加入咗，如果能夠當選加入教育局嘅時候咧，佢會係摸索喺教育局裏邊嘅工作，希望咧佢呢個咁嘅開放同埋啊容易接觸嘅態度咧，係容易接觸多啲我哋嘅家長。任何時間去呢個教育局嘅 office 啦，或者係打電話俾佢咧，佢都盡可能咧係去接見我哋嘅家長，希望咧佢呢種開明嘅態度咧係幫到我哋嘅家長。而頭先講過佢幾個嘅抱負啦，就係、話爭取啊平均嘅資源啊，啊改善呢個教育嘅制度咧方面咧，佢希望咧除咗呢啲之外，佢將來喺繼續做嘅時候咧，佢叫做摸索有探討佢嘅新嘅方向嘅。Okay, we understand your direction, your political agenda, or your ambition already.、Mm-hmm. So there are other candidate, I suppose.
Absolutely.
I believe so. Right. Mm-hmm. It's a, such a large area.
Yeah.
So in that case, can you summarize for us or more impressive for us how to impress our voter? Why people should vote for you, Anastasia?
Absolutely. They should vote for me because I'm going to be their voice. And I have a very loud voice. And I'm going to be their voice at the board level.And my guiding principle will be, how will any decision I make at the board level going to affect the classroom, going to affect their children? And there's a large population of new Canadians in the Chinese community, and they have to know that I will advocate for them. I will be available for them. If there's a problem at the school that can't be resolved, be it a language issue, be it anything, and you can't attain a resolution through the teachers and the principal, you call your trustee.And the trustee will come in, and you know what? We'll get a positive resolution. Sometimes it's a language barrier. Sometimes it's misunderstanding on both parts. Mm-hmm. But it's definite, it can be resolved. And you need to go to your trustee, and I will do that for you. And you can teach me Cantonese while we do that.
All right.
Or Mandarin. I don't care.
So you'll be liaison between the school and the parents and try to get a positive resolution for
Absolutely.
Them.
Absolutely. Right.
Okay. And Anastasia 說呢就是在雲雲的候選人之中呢佢覺得自己係一個適合嘅候選人，因為佢會採取一個開明嘅態度，容易接觸到我哋嘅家長。有需要嘅時候咧，係歡迎家長去揾佢嘅。佢覺得佢希望喺教育局裏邊去發聲，佢會係好大聲，佢會係好感言，係為我哋嘅家長去爭取。佢希望每一個決定，佢都要明白係會點樣影響到我哋嘅課堂，點樣影響到我哋學生。所以希望咧，家長都有參與嘅機會。如果家長有乜嘢嘅意見，或者有乜嘢嘅投訴，或者啲關注嘅地方，如果唔能夠得到一個解決嘅方法，即使佢哋同學校嘅教師或者係校長磋商之後，都未能夠解決嘅時候咧，佢歡迎各位家長係去聯絡佢。佢呢個教育委員嘅角色咧，就會幫助喺中間嘅係調停同埋去磋商。所以如果大家家長喺教育方面有咩需要嘅時候咧，佢係好歡迎各位嘅家長咧去聯絡佢嘅。咁喺呢方面咧，我哋好多謝佢係熱心係服務呢個社區。咁最後咧，我哋再恭祝佢咧喺今次嘅試選裏邊咧係成功當任呢個教育嘅委員。So Anastasia, so we then understand that you'll be readily available for our parents in case they need to find the school trustee. So we really hope you will successful. You'll be successful in your election.
Thank you.
Thanks so much for your time in coming.
Thank you very much for having me. Thank you, everyone. And remember to vote on October 27th.
係啦，多謝各位聽眾收聽。咁 Anastasia 咧呼籲我哋喺選舉日記住10月27日係記得出嚟投票嘅。好多謝各位。
以上內容純屬個人言論，所提及嘅政綱均以嘉賓原話為準，並不代表本台立場。敬請留意立場，敬請留意立場，敬請留意立場。